One, two, three, four.
Blah, 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 Bloodborne.
Blah, 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 Bloodborne. No, don't look at the spoilers for future playthroughs. No, don't. Don't do that.
Today, we're going to do the DLC for Bloodborne.
I have to edit this now.
Why?
Because they saw spoilers for future playthroughs.
Oh.
They saw other characters I was going to do. Damn it! Now I have to cut this audio out! Alright, is there anything? No, I specifically set it up, so... Okay, this is the Fire Wolf look. Just a different garb and a different hat.
Still the same gloves? Still the same skirt?
Yes.
Okay.
And the weapons are all the same, except it's the torch instead of the Hunter's torch, because why not? Let's look at those stats. These are our current stats.
Vitality 50, Endurance 20, Strength 40, Skill 25, Blood Tinge 6, Arcane 15.
I'm working on getting Arcane up so we can do the, Arcane weapons. Pick this up.
Blood. Wait, was that four bloodstone chunks?
Possibly, yes.
Oh my gosh, dude.
It's not.
That's. Oh, wait a minute.
Not much. It's not a rock.
I forgot.
Yeah. You can start.
You want me to start?
Mm-hmm.
The eye of a blood-drunk hunter. Its pupil is collapsed and turned to mush, indicating the onset of the scourge of beasts.
Is it mush or mush?
I think it'd be taken either way.
A hunter who goes drunk with blood is said to be taken by the nightmare, destined to wander forever, engaged in an endless hunt. It is a fate no hunter can escape. Let's go not escape it. Let's go enter that nightmare now. Yay. I'm thinking we can get this done in 3 sessions. Like, each session is one of the areas.
Let's get it done in this hour.
This hour? Oh.
We got half an hour.
Oh, Christ. Maybe. No. I've never found the Sinister Resonant Bell, I don't think. I don't know. Maybe you find it in the Chalice Dungeons or something. It's so you can invade other worlds, other characters.
Well, you've never been on really online, have you?
What?
Isn't that...
No, no, no. Yeah, no, you need PS Plus to do that. Why?
Exactly.
Do I just have the option to do... I didn't even light the lamp. Why is this open? What? Oh, my God.
Wouldn't you
have... I'm an idiot. I'm such a fucking idiot. We're not in the DLC yet. I'm in the actual Cathedral Ward. I have not been... For some reason, in my head, I got picked up by that alien already. Alright, hey. Right here, the body. Look at my slender body, ripe for the grabbins. Woo! Hey, beautiful.
Wow, your health bar is really high.
Yeah, it's 50. That's the soft cap, I think.
Cursed fiends, their children.
It's too bad the stamina doesn't get that high without the health being that high very easily.
After stamina gets to 40, they barely give you any after. That's the game telling you to fucking stop pumping stamina. So curse the fiends, their children too, and their children forever true. The Healing Church, Bergenworth, had a curse put on them. And then, so that carried over to their children, and every subsequent member. We just happened to be a hunter. Hunters are a branch of the Healing Church. So we're cursed! That's cool.
We love curses.
Oh, they're the best. Especially when you accidentally apply a cursed blood gem that, takes away 9 health per second and don't realize it till you die because you're in the dream. Good way to get yourself killed in the dream. So remember when I said this is back in time?
Yeah.
I was right. It's not forward in time. It's all jacked up because this is a memory. And those like weird fucking bits are poorly remembered.
Huh.
Anywho. There's...
Remember when I was playing and I dropped down into that one guy?
Yeah, that was pretty great. This is always fun, just watching this happen. Cool. Alright, well...
Well, now you know.
Now I gotta deal with that. Itching my eyeball. Oh, God!
He seems okay.
He's super okay. He's the best. He's a great guy.
Was.
Was a great guy. He's probably a great guy, too. Let's go talk to him.
Looks about like this. Ow!
Jesus!
I think the stairs saved you.
I think so, too. Oh.
Nice. Worked out anyway.
Nice, yeah. Oh wait, which runes do I have applied right now? Blood Rapture, the best one, Air, looks like a good one, and Moon, okay.
You have four runes applied?
Yeah, there's a special rune. The fourth one is a special one, so it's blue ones only.
Okay.
Hunter, stamina recovery speed goes up, corruption, continue healing your death plus one, that's fucking useless. And then this is gonna help us out for the bosses. The one I have applied right now.
Okay.
And there's a bunch of other kind of useless ones that I held on to for story purposes once we get to a certain point.
Okay.
It's the, more or less towards the end of the second area.
I love stories.
I fucking love story. I've been reading Lovecraft. And god fucking damn it, it's so much like Bloodborne, it's ridiculous. All this fucking Cthulhu shit going around. You get the torch out just because they're more scared of fire. They're least likely to attack you. Less likely to attack you when you have fire out. Pretty sure these ones are just pussies anyways. I mean, this feels weird after using the scythe for so long.
Well, now they know that you use the scythe.
They know I'm trying to get good at every weapon. Found out what those marks next to the antidote are. The one that's a ribcage pointing, yeah, in the top left.
Oh, okay.
Finally found out what those are. Those are blood gem effects. And I have a blood gem on the blunderbuss that gives me plus 2 health every second. And then on the saw cleaver, it's really good damage output, but it subtracts the amount of damage I do to beasts, specifically. Which clearly is not a problem.
I think it is.
Oh yeah, because they're only going down in 2 shots instead of 1.
Right.
I leave those beasts alive so that they're distracted by so that they distract the hunter.
Seems to be working.
It worked. It worked. Look how well it worked.
Oh, that's about how high my stamina is on my playthrough.
Up to 20?
I think. Well, I just remember seeing it just barely past the.
Consumables.
Yeah.
Oh, here comes him. There's only one beast to really distract
him. His name is him?
Yeah, that guy's name is him. He's actually. It's probably got the richest backstory of all of Bloodborne. The good character named him. And I just visceraled him way too easily. He should have turned around.
Well, he was ending his attack sequence with that monster.
Ah, yes. Have I found any of the new... Did I forget to grab the beast cutter? I think I forgot to grab the beast cutter.
The beast flutter?
Yes, the beast flutter. I did not. I did! Beast cutter. Right here. No, those are the old hunter gloves. Where the fuck is the beast... Did I pick it up? I did not. Where'd I leave it? Is it in a different place than I thought? I think it is. It is. Okay, never mind. Oops. Came back here for nothing. Well, came back here for gloves. And to be fair, they are better than the ones I have right now. Substantially better.
It's just gloves.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. And my vitality's high enough, it doesn't really matter? Like, what level am I at? 106. Okay, we're good. If you're past level 100, you should be okay with this. Oh, that should've hit you. That's bullshit. I'm not used to not having the scythe. The scythe, there. It's a little too close to scythe for me. I got confused in my head. That was difficult. Bitches, I'm home! Yeah.
12 points of damage.
Yeah, the Hunter's Torch actually could be a viable weapon. I'm pretty sure it can take these guys down in like 4 hits. It was fortified, of course. I don't know if you can even fortify the regular torch. Does it even have a damage? It does. Durability. Okay. Oh, I didn't fucking see you! Christ!
Behind the pillar.
Christ on a bike! Woo! Should have remembered you, though. Vials.
And... Gosh dang. Good thing you're picking up blood vials, because you know I'm going to use them.
I don't know how many we got storage, but I grinded off the pigs at the end for a while, so we should be good on vials. Do I see the hunter up there? He's not there yet. Is he there now? Okay, there he is.
Yep.
Here he comes. You can take care of those guys for me. Cool.
He goes so hard on those guys.
Right? They're just like, no, 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 no. Hi, guy! Just getting wrecked.
He missed quite a bit of those guys, too. I bet if you just stand there, he won't get you. Oh, my gosh.
Holy fuck, he doesn't know I'm here. Okay, he knows I'm here. Oh!
Okay, so he misses those other guys, but he can't hit you, or but he hits you every time?
Jesus!
I don't get it.
Oh, he's got... Oh, this guy has high defense. No! Good. Fuck!
Oh, no.
No. I'll be down here.
What? Did he just forget you were there?
I think so.
Yep, he did.
Dummy. Oh, we were treading on thin fucking water there. He almost stepped on that button. Which would have set off that turret. Did I pick up the beast cutter? No. It's up there, though.
You did. Did you not get that item?
The fuck? Oh, it's just bullets.
Well, you're running low on bullets anyway.
Currently. Got plenty in storage. So yeah, let's get that beast cutter. It's right there.
Ooh, yeah!
Let's take a look at some of the new stuff we got. We got an old hunter cap.
We got old hunter gloves, old hunter cap with a wide brim that hides their sharp gaze. In the old days, when hunters were 10 a penny, this part was of their standard garb.
Old hunter gauntlets made of brass to protect their weapon-bearing hands. At the time, some hunters believed that certain metals would ward off beast blood. On a night of the hunt, it's no wonder that some resort to superstition. Did we get the pants? Did.
Old hunter trousers that protect the countless hunters from the beasts in their older age. In an older age. A widespread belief of the period was that beast blood crept up on the right leg, and this led to the double wrapped belt.
On the right, yeah, you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. And the cutter. A trick weapon wielded by the old hunters. This thick iron cleaver slices through the toughest of beast hides. It's serrated, that means it's good against beasts. And when transformed, the blade splits into sections, allowing one to lash it in fashion of a heavy whip.
A heavy whip. This crude weapon relies on brute force and is regrettably inelegant, suggesting that the hunts of the earliest hunters made for horrific affairs, painted in sanguine blacks and reds.
So it's... It's hard to look at. Okay, here we go. It's... Definitely. Oh, it's a strength weapon. Yeah, it's a strength weapon, definitely. We can look at his moveset. It's just a fucking heavy ass serrated mace. And then the cool part. And I found this out. It doesn't have a charge. Huh. In its extended form, you just tap it and it does that. Same as if you hold it.
I think they changed their cheese.
Their cheese? Oh. Chris is eating pizza, for those of you who don't know. This part is hilariously easy. Cool. All right. And then there's a Cthulhu fatty. Like, half the fucking enemies in this opening area are killed for me. Alright, well. Oh, good opportunity! Good opportunity! Bye!
What?
I'm running past this motherfucker.
Why?
Because we're coming back out this way. We're just running in here for this item in here.
Alright.
And when we come back out, he'll have his back to us. Which is quite convenient.
Cleric beast!
It is a cleric beast, yes. Eye pendant! What do you want, Rocky? An eye pendant which unlocks the surgery altar. There are two cathedrals in the Hunter's Dream. One lies past the River of Blood. And one contains the private research hall of the Healing Church. Yeah. Only chosen members of the Healing Church or their lamentable patients can enter their research hall using this eye. Grant eyes to the surgery. Alrighty. Chris! You're ripping plastic, why?
I love it.
Why are you ripping that plastic, boy? See? This guy's back to us. He just became immediately easier. Also, those other guys damaged him for me.
A little bit.
A little bit. I mean, dude, this is gonna do a bit, so.
And you're gonna do him in. Oh, what? He's not dead? Thought you were gonna kill him.
Easy to get two viscerals on him. You can just, if you're really weak, you can chain viscerals against these guys if you're behind them. Not hard.
I think I've seen you use 3 blood vials so far.
Yeah, well. And I just got,
and
like,
12. And you've gained, like, 20.
Fuck, man, we're gonna need him against the Orphan of Kaz.
Maybe.
Mayhap. I mean, I'm okay. I don't know why that was so funny. And we got some, I forget what they're called. They're not powder kegs yet. It's not what they call themselves yet. Okay.
He's wearing the old hunter clothing.
He is. And a top hat.
And a top hat.
Old Hunter top hat as opposed to the old Hunter cap. Oh, I'm glad you just said that. We gotta go back. I missed the old Hunter's garb. You'd sell the, oh, by the way, skeleton of an amygdala. So that's cool. I mean,
well, that's interesting.
Yeah, right? After learning what I've learned, I'd figure the sky would look a little bit different. Learning what I've learned about the DLC, which I will tell you in time. It has to do with that fucking shell falling out of the sky on us.
Okay.
Oh, is it over here? Where is it? Forgot where you get it from. Over... Aha, there it is. And this might have a different description.
Old Hunter garb. One day the hunters disappeared, and Yarnamites began to whisper of the hunter's sin. Drunk with blood chasing after beasts, they would pass on them to the nightmare, every last one of them.
Including me! Yay! Oh, I'm... Dude, I am drenched in the blood.
You seem okay.
Yeah.
What?
Take a screenshot of that shit. It's all shimmery, I like it. I think we're close to a lamp, maybe? Awesome. Yeah, we're right next to the River of Blood. So yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that so we could go grab that. I think it sells for, like, almost nothing at all. But it's cool to have! And then sell!
I think it'd be cool if they had, like, sets of armor that were you could put on for these, the statues. At the Hunter's Dream or something?
Oh, like have statues in the Hunter's Dream and just like put armor on them?
Yeah.
Like an Assassin's Creed type thing?
Kind of, yeah.
I saw that in, I think it was Unity? So yeah,
there was another game that was like that. Skyrim was like that.
Oh, I would not know. Hi. Cool, bye.
You may even not know either because I had all the DLC for it and it might require you to have DLC to
oh,
do that.
Oh, yeah. Well, I have the DLC on the PC.
Okay.
But can't really play Skyrim on my current PC.
Oh, look. A trap! Seems okay.
Yeah, it's fine. Don't worry about it. The hammer's okay.
Is it worth it to get the hammer?
I mean, if you want to use the hammer, it probably sells for a little bit.
If you're a heavy weapons kind of person, is it?
You know, it's totally worth it if you know the trap is there, because it's super easy to not get hurt by it. So yeah, it's totally worth it. Now this is a beast hunter. Not very many beast hunters in the game.
Nothing but a oh.
Right.
He's got pretty high endurance.
I have fire paper equipped? I do not.
Oh gosh. Oh gosh, I remember last time I did this.
I equipped it, then I de-equipped it. I got this. Cool. Wow! Okay.
Wow. That was some samurai shit.
Right? So he's a beast, so obviously he's weak to fire. Oh, I'm so used to the scythe. Just dash forward and get him. Yeah, he's not too much of a problem. Uh-huh, that's what I thought, motherfucker. Firing hammer badge. I think with that you can get the boom hammer from the shop and also delayed molotovs. Just a whole bunch of that flamey shit.
Okay.
Flamio Hotman. Oh, that was an Avatar reference. Just so you know.
I don't know that.
Yeah, okay. And the top hat!
Yeah!
Look at that shit!
Oh, it's so cute.
Yeah.
Old hunter top hat, warped by bloodstains. In old days, when hunters were 10 a penny, this was part of their standard garb.
It was repeating. So,
there's an item to your right.
Oh, actually, we want to do this first. We want to sprint up these stairs and get this guy. Because if you ignore him and those other guys see you, he'll walk out onto that bridge, and you'll have to deal with two of them at the same time. And when they have those guns, that's not fun to do.
You gonna pick out the other gun, guys?
I'm gonna go this direction down the river first. Fuck!
Oh no.
It's fine! Tombstones. They are my best friend.
No.
See, it's fine.
Here we go. You ever tried to visceral those guys?
I have. I've been able to successfully charge attack their backs and nothing happened from it, so I don't think you can visceral them. They don't look very visceralable. If that is a word. Are you? Okay, well. Oh, what?
Nailed it.
Yeah, totally nailed it.
Oh boy.
This is me nailing it.
Oh boy. You got it. Yeah, I guess you're not health back.
It's all good. It's all good. I'm only really worried about the Gatling gun guy in the cave of holy shit. I mean, it deserves its name. It has a fucking boss in it and a Gatling gun guy. Get some more stamina back. And that's it for them.
Ooh! Yeah! Bonus buddy!
He has chunks. He has chunks!
Chunks!
All the chunks!
Cave of holy shit.
Right? Because holy shit.
Oh, he's got a,
Saw spear.
Yeah.
Which is not a particularly good weapon. I don't think. It's decent, I guess.
I thought it was just the same kind of as a Cycleaver.
More or less. Except in its extended form, it's more of a thrusting weapon. And it scales better with skill than it does with strength. He already used his blood vial, so don't have to worry about that. Ah!
Oh.
Okay, good time to run. You get stun locked like that. What? Okay, sure.
He got shot, man. He jumped into the bullets.
Yeah, but the way he reacted to it was weird. Ow! What's this pain? You jumped into a fucking bullet that would have not hit you otherwise! Hi. Oh, wow. A lot more hit points than I thought. See, they're afraid of the fire. Now come here. See? Oh! You sneaky motherfuckers!
He showed you. And Bloodstife Beast!
Yay.
Just not on fire. Or not causing you any
friends. I was gonna say, the last one wasn't on fire either. Fuck! I hate that.
It's poison damage that he does, not friends of your
fire.
I remember he did some sort of status effect.
It was definitely poison. Trying to get a charge attack on the back so I can visceral, but it's not working out for me. Fuck off! I'll just kill you normal. There.
Didn't you say the guys level or scale with your level on this game?
No.
Even in the main story?
Yeah, they don't do that at all.
Oh, so if you grinded up until this point, you'd be able to just murder everybody then?
More or less what I'm doing. I'm as high level as you can be without grinding super hard right before coming here. We can read the boom hammer.
A trick weapon used by the old hunters crafted by the workshop heretics, the powder kegs. A giant hammer equipped with a miniature furnace. When ignited and fired, it emits a volley of flame that explodes furiously upon impact. Crush the beasts, then burn them, then brute simplicity of Boomhammer was favored by hunters with an acute distaste for beasts.
So yeah, when you transform it, you only have one shot of fire, and then it goes back to being normal. But, do that, wait. Yeah, see, you can transform attack it into fire. So, if you just tricked it, attack, transformation attack, attack. They basically got three.
Huh.
They're a bit slower, but it works like that. And the Amygdalan arm. The arm of a small Amygdala great one. Strictly speaking, the Amygdalan arm is no trick weapon of any sort, but certain madmen wield them like clubs. Yay!
Caveman. Ugh.
Starts as a large, tough, blunt weapon formed of bone. But when extended, the hand quivers as if it were still alive. Dude, did you see the fucking charge attack on this thing?
No.
Look at this shit. That's it.
What? It's like three attacks.
Yeah. Boom, that'll knock them down, and that's supposed to hit them while they're down.
Huh.
Like, it's fucking brutal. I think it's a strength weapon. It's probably a strength weapon. It's a strength weapon.
Yeah.
Alright, and thus concludes the Cave of Holy Shit. How many mosquito fucking ladies did I leave over there?
I think there were four.
Yeah, there's the ones under the bridge, and then there's the one in the cavern over there. Not cavern, but like the end of the river.
And I wish I was still in high school.
Yeah?
So that I could eat more.
So you could eat more?
Yeah. There's one more piece of pizza left. And it's so tempting. But I'm so full. Oh no.
Fuck! Fuck! Whoa! Whoa! Ah! I'll go down here, it's fine. See? It's fine. It's my escape route.
You gonna try and get your health back?
I got it all back. You motherfucker need to go. What the fuck are they doing up here? They don't come up here.
They do now.
Now they're trying to get away. Yeah. They're like, no, this is not where we belong. No. No, scurry away, Margaret. Scurry away. Fuck do you think you're going? Yeah, tell me more. And then there's this little thing. We missed this last time. Little path going up.
Yeah, I don't remember that path at all.
Which leads to Constable's trousers? Gloves. Constable's gloves.
Wait, what was that gesture?
That was the monocular. It's an item.
It's about a time a troop of foreign constables. Yep, I read that right. Mm-hmm. Chased a beast all the way to the Yharnam. And this is what they were. War. The constables...
This is what they were! Holds out a glove.
The constables became victim of the beast, except for one survivor, who in turn devoured the creature whole, all by himself. Wow. This fable is a favorite among Yharnamites, who are partial to any stories of Pompous.
That's a describing word, Chris. Pompous intolerant foreigners who suffer for their ignorance. It makes the blood taste that much sweeter. So the guy that did that is actually... someone you can summon for the Ludwig boss. Hmm. He's actually the leader of the league. And he uses a whirligig. A flaming whirligig.
Whoa. Dude. You're completely covered in so much blood.
I'm covered in the blood.
And does it slowly fade away after over time?
Nope. It washes off when you go to the dream. Shortcut back to the lamp.
Yeah!
Hey, hey, Simon.
You're a hunter with your sanity, aren't you?
I mean, can you tell from how much blood I'm covered in that I'm completely sane?
Well, we're more alike than you think.
No, you're completely opposite. It's you're completely clean.
Nightmare. We're white and red. It's like...
blood cells.
Yeah!
Aimless, wandering hunters slavering like beasts. This is what the poor fools have to look forward to. Don't be brash. Turn back before it's too late. Unless you've something of an interest in nightmares.
Nightmares are fascinating. You sense a secret within the night. This should be hurting him. It's clipping through his body like that. The spirit of Bergenworth
lives on within you. Such inquisitive hunters will relish the nightmare. But beware. Secrets are secrets for a reason, and some do not wish to see them uncovered.
I want him to stop talking, like, especially when the- Okay, what the fuck are you doing?
I don't think so. And
bye! Kill him. No. He's got a quest line. It does end with him dying, though, don't worry.
Alright.
Everyone in Bloodborne fucking dies!
Let it go this time.
He's a good guy, Chris.
Oh, they're having a little knitting party. She's late.
What?
What was that?
Who did you find? Is there someone else? Well, let's do this shit again. This three times isn't enough. Fuck. It's fine. Oh.
Nailed it!
Completely nailed it! Alright. That went what? So fucking well! That went so well!
She totally missed!
Damn!
Son?
Who are you shooting at? There's nothing over here. There's nothing over here. Alright, whatever. There's dogs. But you're not hostile to dogs. There's a hunter over there, but I think they're probably hostile to hunters.
Yeah.
I remember, is this it? No, this is not it. This is... Cold Blood.
Frenzied Cold Blood!
Tier 9. Remember, we came over this way.
Yeah.
And this guy scared the shit out of me because I thought he was a hunter, but he's actually just a regular villager. Now this guy's a hunter. Well, that just wasn't fair.
Blair!
I keep on thinking that's an attack. I keep on doing shooting at the wrong time. Fuck.
I see. Wow.
Oh! Wow. You come on over here. It'll be much easier to fight you in close quarters.
Well, alright. And okay. Yep, he just said, screw you.
He gave up on it. Hi. There we go.
Oh!
Then there's that crow. And that crow. Oh, and this crow. And I think that's it for the crows here.
This is no dog crows or crow dogs.
Not yet, anyways. There is another hunter. There's the scythe over there. And then there's some clothing right there. Clothing that did belong to one called Constable.
Wasn't I the one that went across here first? Or
yes.
Were you?
Oh, I was, but you told me to.
Okay.
It was your idea. Constable's garb. All the constable's clothing has the same description. That's not why we're not looking at the other stuff.
What do you want?
Rocky, quit looking at us with your eyes! And quit winking. With one eye. That was a little weird. Hi, Scythe guy! Okay, well, alright. Well, you know what? I think he doesn't have very much. Oh yeah, he actually has more defense than usual. Damn it! I keep thinking their transformations are attacks. Bitch.
You visceral yourself.
I don't understand how that would work. There's the scythe. It's actually a really good fucking weapon. It's skill based.
Can you use that weapon yet?
Yeah.
A trick weapon used by the old hunters. A second blade is found inside the curve of the main one. In its initial form, the scythe can be wielded like a long, curved sword, but when transformed, its blade is contracted, allowing for quick, repeatable stabs. Although this trick weapon allows for adaptive combat, it was later replaced by saws and similar weapons that were more effective at disposing of beasts.
But it's super good on its own! So yeah, it starts off extended, but the transformation is actually like this. And this fucking dash at the beginning is so good! It's a distance closing attack, do you? Oh, it's so fucking good! So good! But it's 0% fortified, and it's also not the Fire Lord weapon, so we're sticking to the cleaver. Are you doing okay? I mean, you guys are not, but... That crow, just dancing. Nice. The two Cthulhu fatties on the River of Blood out here are also incredibly easy if you know what to do.
Yeah, I remember.
Just run. Just straight up start running. And they won't even see you, and they'll have their backs to you. There's skulls in that rock? Looks like it, huh?
Kinda.
Do you know the church cannon that we find in the cathedral?
Yeah.
It's actually what he's holding. He's holding a very large church cannon.
Oh.
Yeah. Super cool. Oh, fuck! You know, I was kind of convinced that would visceral you.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, frame rate, please. Oh!
You got hit.
I did! Oh. It's fine. Dance
oh,
circles!
No. Oh no.
Dance circles! Oh, it's this attack. That's fine if we're far away. Dance!
Dance, water!
Alright, 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 alright! Okay.
You gonna forget about him?
I'm gonna do this. Oh, hi, witch. She just does not give a shit that you're here, ever. And he's giving- okay, let's try that visceral again.
He turns around and viscerals you.
No, he's not even a hunter! He's a big old fucking Lovecraftian monster. There's no way he can visceral me.
You're covered in a lot of blood.
I've been rolling through a fucking river of this stuff. Quite- Fuck! Uh-oh. Okay.
What was gonna happen?
He was making the noise he makes before, that tentacle attack. Tentacle grab. Let's actually visceral him! Yay! And then it takes two. Which is not hard to do. Although apparently one is incredibly difficult. To be fair, I did profit blood vials from that still. We're not touching that till we go after Ludwig. But, you can read the description. The Butcher's Mask.
Mask of the Matterous Twins. Denizens of the Forbidden Woods, likely belonging to the older of the two. The twins grew up in the silent kinship with a poisonous snake. Eventually, they learned human ways and became hunters. When they discovered vermin even in their beloved snakes, their younger brother is said to have murdered the older. Nasty, nasty murder.
Cool, and I think this has the same...
No.
Oh. Garb of the Madaris twins, then... Yeah. Both the twins became hunters and brought back and dissected their beast prey in order to support the villagers in their forbidden research. And this might be the same. Yes. This too. Yes. Fuck off, Rocky. Notice I haven't gone back to the dream at all yet, and I currently have 120,000 blood echoes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm living on the edge right now. Go ahead, get my vials from you. Everyone I've seen play this so far does not know about that, and it's incredible to me. Because he's fucking banging on the gate, you would hear him, and you would think...
You can get two hunters for that boss, can't you?
Yes. That's what we're gonna do. Because goddamn it, he's bullshit. It gives him more health, but it's honestly worth it. Like that.
You gonna go back to the hunter's dream?
Not yet. Gonna finish off this area. Right before the boss is when we'll go to the dream. Is he here yet? There he is. Look at that motherfucker. Sitting up there. We'll summon Henriette to help us a little bit. Although she's probably not gonna do much at all. You can see his shadow right there on the wall.
Yeah.
Hi. Cool. Thanks for the help, Henriette! Oh. Again, you were a... Yeah.
She got him!
Yep.
Good effort. She's got the Kirk hammer.
She does. Alright, I'll let you kill somebody, Henriette.
Let's see, isn't that the... No, I used a different sword in my playthrough.
What sword are you using?
Remember the other... Oh, I don't remember what it's called now.
Ludwig's Holy Blade?
Yes.
Oh. I've been practicing with that. Let's just walk. If you don't sprint, then it won't hit you. Cool. So yeah, that fell out of the sky. Every time I play this, I looked for a place that it could have been launched from, like a fucking catapult or something. But no. It straight up came out of the sky itself. And we'll find out why eventually. Wilkig!
A trick weapon. I'll just let you read this. It's one of your favorites.
A trick weapon. A trick weapon crafted by the workshop heretics, the powder kegs. A weapon of choice for the old hunter, Valtir, the beast eater.
Ew.
With the constable clothing guy. This weapon pummels beasts in its mace form, but its true strength lies in the attached mechanical saws. These discs, lined with serrated teeth, spin rapidly, thrashing the flesh of beasts into fine shreds.
And what makes those blades spin?
The force. But yeah, here's the mace moveset that nobody cares about because it's just the fucking mace. Charge attack, yeah, whatever. And... oh yeah! This fucking shit!
And why are there sparks?
I don't know. Charge attack! Knocks him down and grinds him
don't
a little
forget
bit
about the other one.
And then the L2, which just... if you ever got people, you just... that's really good if you got high stamina. And then we'll look at the transformation attacks. Which, that's the less cool. I mean, that's pretty cool, actually. And then there's this one. Yeah, the transformation attack from saw to mace is actually probably a better transformation attack. Because you're just holding the fucking saw by itself. Okay. That's that for that. We're good. We can go back to the dream now.
Yes.
Ooh.
Get out of here, Henriette.
Can't you resummon her?
Well, you can't go, but you can't use a Bolt Hunter's Mark while you have partners.
Oh.
That's why I got rid of her.
You know, you never really used Bolt Hunter's Mark from what I ever saw.
I've been using them a lot more recently.
Okay.
Just for stuff like that.
Ever since I did?
Eh.
It seemed like once I started using them, then you started using them too.
I suppose. Once my paths... stopped stopping at a lamp and started stopping at a random spot like that. Damn, though, I got 124,000 blood echoes. I think that's enough for 2 or 3 upgrades.
We'll find out. We're gonna put them into Arcane?
Yeah, till Arcane gets to 20. Do I have any cold blood?
Yes.
I do. BRB. Oh yeah, and I decidedly did not fight Marigo. Marigo's wet nurse. Just so that we could have the music in here. And it not be on fire. Do they need fortified? Okay. It's good. Sell some stuff.
You're gonna get... Never mind. No, you're not.
Huh.
I was gonna ask if you were gonna get rid of some of your insight, but you need insight to summon.
Yeah. Rear the scythe. Beast cutter is 10,000. Boom hammer is 14,000. Whirly gig is 15,000. Amygdala is 19,800. Gatling gun is 15,000. Oh! 1,000. 2,000. 1,000. So we got the full old hunter set. Plus the top hat. We need something church related, so I'll hold on to that. And we want frenzy resistance for later. Constable's garb is 10,000. The gloves are 5,000.
Chargers are 5,000.
Did we miss out on the hat of the constable?
I don't know.
We did. It's a helmet type thing. 1,500 for that. This is a cheaper one. But all that, we just got ourselves up to 258,000 blood echoes.
Which we started at 125 something.
Did we?
Something about like that.
Fuck!
Yeah, you gained a lot of stuff.
We went up three levels.
Three levels? Damn.
It's pretty good for where I'm at right now, because I grinded.
Do you remember how much arcane we need for that sword?
For the sword? I think 14.
Okay.
Which, now we have 18, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, we can wield the sword once we get it now. Which we're about to after we fight the next boss.
Yeah.
Which is what we want the church thing for. There's a way to talk to him without him going absolutely fucking nuts.
That's a computer charger.
Ah.
A laptop charger, I suppose.
Yeah, I recognize it. It fits my mom's laptop.
Huh.
I think. It fits the laptop we've had before, I think, maybe. I recognize it. There. I'll leave it at that. Fortunately for us, we have to go through these guys again just to get to one of the guys that are gonna help us.
Why is that fortune?
I was being sarcastic. Although I guess you could say it's fortunate because it means we get more blood echoes.
Yeah, as long as you can deal with them this time.
Clearly not a problem, look at this shit.
You're doing okay, this time.
It's easy to do when you actually hit him when you do the attack.
Yeah, definitely.
See, we're fine. Even if I did have to fight him legit now, it wouldn't be that big of a problem. Which
and
I don't.
You don't. Well, there's 50,000 right off the bat.
12,000.
Where'd the other 40 come from?
What? Leftover from when I could not upgrade.
Oh.
They gave me 6,000 each. So this is the younger Madara's twin. The guy that was raised by a snake and then killed his older twin. So that's cool, he's gonna help us. Right?
And then Henrietta?
Nope, not Henriette. If we get Henriette, then the other two guys we're summoning will disappear.
Oh.
Because Henriette's an old hunter, these guys are confederates.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Cool. Pebbles, please. Thank you. Blood vials?
Blood childs?
Yeah, the younger Madara's twin, and then past these crows.
I saw that in there earlier, but I didn't know if that was actually a summoning place or not.
Master Valtir. Now, this is the guy that chased down and ate a beast.
Yeah.
He's also the guy you talk to about getting the rune that helps you get these helpers. He's the leader of the Confederacy. Come on out. Yeah. See, he's got a whirligig.
He's wearing a bucket for a helmet.
Yep, he sure is. It's only got one eye hole. If it has an eye hole, I'm pretty sure it has an eye hole. Oh well. Whatever. It's not important. Something interesting about this next boss fight, too. I'll point it out when we get to it. That guy, begging for help, can survive the fight if neither you nor Ludwig hit him.
Okay.
But it's unlikely, given the fact that Ludwig moves around quite a bit.
So if he survives, what do you get any bonuses or anything?
You get to talk to him, and he goes, he's just laughing.
Oh.
Probably in a, holy fuck, I can't believe I'm still alive kind of laugh.
Eyeballs!
I bet his breath is great. Fun fact, Bloodborne is actually just a really long advertisement for Orbit. For this one particular scene. Yeah, he's not nearly as intimidating to me anymore. My last two times I fought him, I killed him on my first try.
Okay.
Good start, though. Haunches! Aim for the haunches!
Yeah, oh man.
It's fine.
Well, there's three of you now.
Exactly, so we're fine. He's super distracted all the time. If he gets on me, then I can just dodge him for a few seconds and he'll start attacking someone else.
It's working out, great.
Every now and then something like that'll hit me, but it's not that big of a deal.
Oh yeah, he's still. We use the stairs all the time.
Yeah. Ah, fuck!
You didn't even get touched.
Yeah, but okay. Woohoo!
I can't believe you didn't get hit right there.
It does three drips from the ceiling, and then you dodge. Oh, this is good.
Damn.
He's a lot more trouble now for some reason. It was quite easy my last two times.
Maybe you might be overconfident.
No, I'm good. Okay, well.
Well, this is a second easier stage, isn't it?
Yeah, this stage is easier, and I've still got two helpers. He has two AoE attacks. One where he aims the sword down, you want to run away from that. One where he aims the sword up, you want to get hit by that. You want to stay close to him and be behind him, because after that he'll always do a slash downwards that could quite possibly one-shot you.
Okay.
Holy Moonlight Sword, it's in all the Dark Souls games. And I'm pretty sure it's also in Demon Souls. My true Well, maybe not in the hour of eight, but in an hour, which surprises me. We've got about 5 minutes to beat this boss. Which shouldn't be too difficult. He says right before dying immediately. Cool! Yeah, this you want to back away from. Unless your friends fucking stun him out of it, which is great. Alright, cool.
How did that even happen?
They hit him to the point where he just wasn't gonna do it anymore, I guess. Visceral, motherfucker! Ooh, in your nutsack. And that automatically means we're gonna get more blood echoes from this fight. So yeah, this one you just wanna take, because it hardly hits you at all. And then he does that attack. That right there. Which will fucking murder you.
Oh my gosh. Yes.
Did the guy survive?
No.
I don't think he survived. It's okay, I got recording of him.
Roman, guidance.
Yeah, thanks guys. Cool. Alright, so, just in case he died, I got this. From when I was playing with Luna. Here's him when he survives! This is all he does. Yay! 210 blood echoes! Cool! Alright. And, if you just talk to him, he'll go fucking nuts. But, wear a church outfit.
Tell me, good hunter of the church, have you seen the light? Are my church hunters the honorable Spartans? I hoped they would be.
We're gonna lie to him and say yes.
Ah, good. That is a relief. To know I did not suffer such denigration for nothing. Thank you kindly. Now I may sleep in peace. Even in this darkest of nights, I see the moonlight.
The moonlight. The moonlight. Cool, that's nice. Could you... Alright, cool. Ah!
Yeah!
Ah!
Oh. Oh.
An arcane sword discovered long ago by Ludwig. Discovered. Pretty sure it was left behind by some fucking character from Dark Souls. Probably, maybe, they might be the same universe, who knows? When blue moonlight dances around the sword, and it channels the abysmal cosmos.
Oh my god.
Right? The great blade will hurl a shadowy light wave. It uses a quicksilver bullet. The holy moonlight sword is synonymous with Ludwig, the holy blade, but very few have ever set eyes on the great blade. Whatever guidance it has to offer, it seems to be a very private, elusive sword. Anywho, this is the fucking sword!
That's it's a heavy sword, then.
Uh-huh, and then the charge. Nice. And then,
Transformation? Oh my gosh. Oh, that's so cool.
And here's the L2. Let me get some stamina back. Here's the L2. Uses a quicksilver bullet. R2. Also uses a quicksilver bullet. That was a charge R2. A regular R2. Just a...
That's awesome.
Yeah. Uses bullets, though. I think it's obviously an arcane weapon, but it might be a little bit blood-tinged, too? No.
Huh.
Primarily arcane, and after that strength, and after that skill. Got high requirements, though. Thanks for the sword! You know, I really thought I was gonna get blood echoes from that.
Didn't really kill him all the way.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
Oh, let's try some transformation attacks. Alright.
Ooh.
That seems nice. Alright, well, that's the end of this session. We'll pick it up in the next one going into the second area. The second one will probably be longer because there's a lot more secret stuffs to do.
Yes!
till then.
Later.
Chill out! Chill out!
Thank you. Good boy.
Alright. Wait for it.
And...
wait for it.
And the switch.
Wait for it.
And...
wait for it.
And the switch.
Wait for it.
And... the switch.
Wait for it.
And... the switch.
YMCA! Wait for it. Alright, later. Oh yeah, also audio.